one of the coldest days of May.
You can go grab a coat.
These Craft Meadows Middle School students huddled together to do something new, launch a balloon to the edge of space.
We're just hoping for a good outcome.
Leading the project is Chris Beam.
Payload at the bottom. Shortly thereafter, you'll have the radar dome.
He's hoping this weather balloon launch will connect with kids who are already into math and science. This sixth grader was excited to be picked for the small team made of sixth, seventh, and eighth graders.
Because I knew it would explore like the kind of science that I like and engineering and then also problem solving.
I had one group that did strictly problem solving, one group that did a lot of math equations for me, and then another group that did like a lot of the science aspect, the weather aspect of it.
The load the maiden balloon was carrying was packed with weather equipment to record what the atmosphere feels like high above Caledonia. It also had two GoPros, so the students could see it.
I'm excited to see the footage because I've never really seen anything like that that I've done part of.
After several meetings and calculations and plans, the balloon was filled. The school was called. And the drones were ready. But the first launch wasn't quite a go.
We need some more helium.
Instead, it was a learning lesson, and the kids were set for launch number two. Up, up, and away to the edge of space. This is what West Michigan looks like from the other side of the clouds. The helium carrying the very first weather balloon from Craft Meadows Middle School to the edge of space. Video that's so beautiful, it's bound to make an impression on young minds, both this year and years to come.
I think it will be a good learning experience for them.
I'm Storm Teammate Meteorologist Ellen Baca.
Boy, did Ellen know how to keep us on the edge of our seats or what?
That video
was worth waiting for. How awesome was that?
And it was near the top of the atmosphere, where the part of the atmosphere where the weather occurs, and the sky is blue because of something called Rayleigh scattering. I'm not going to get into that, but you can see in that video it was black because you're above almost all of the air of the atmosphere, and so that process wasn't taking place. So you're looking up and it's black. You're seeing outer space.
That is so cool. Love it. It almost looked like a scene just like straight from a movie. It really was cool to see. Love it. So glad that they did that for us.